Heavenly Father, we ask the blessing on the reading of your word. May your Holy Spirit be our guide today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Doctrines of Salvation, Part 17, Justification. The miracle of justification. So we ended yesterday and we were talking about being condemned. There are many people who will end up in that condemnation. They will end up in the lake of fire because they've ignored the salvation. My prayer is it's none that hear these messages, that you realize that you're a sinner, you've broken God's laws, you've lied, you've stolen, you've coveted, you've done things that deserve the penalty. The wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So one day, here's the picture. We have many sinners who deserve to be in this courtroom. So up to this point, the format of earthly justice has been followed exactly. Jesus is the judge. He's standing in the courtroom going to pronounce the sentence, but something totally unexpected takes place that would cause every earthly court reporter to gasp in utter amazement. The judge has no other choice at this point but to invoke the supreme penalty, death in hell, separation from God, the lake of fire for all eternity, lest justice be denied. But before the terrible sentence can be carried out, the same judge quietly closes the casebook, lays down his heavenly gavel, and takes off his judicial robe, and goes out to die for these convicted defendants. This and this alone is justification. Christ died for you. Why am I justified? My sin has been paid for. How much did I pay for it? None of it. If you're justified, you've realized that Christ paid it all. And there's nothing that you could pay. Why would I serve him? How is it? What do you have for a reason to serve him? What reason do I have to serve him? Well, I have nothing to offer, but I know this, Christ died for me. So that's why I want to serve him. When the judge was given the choice, he had three possibilities. Condemn the man and give him justice. And that will happen to many. They will be condemned because they'll reject their only way out. Some people think he'll clear the man, but God won't do that. He won't clear the man because that would be justice compromised. That would be an option, but he didn't choose that one. The third option was he could clear the guilty through justification, where he laid down his life for you. He chose to do that for all men. Any person that has ever lived can put their trust in him. The Spirit and the bride say, come, whosoever will may come. If you don't know if you're saved today, you can simply trust what he did. But you have to realize there's nothing you can do to add to that. Upon getting saved, if you're saved, no doubt the Lord is working things out in you, and he's telling you you shouldn't do this because it's sin. But that doesn't any more save you, and you're no more saved because you've quit certain sins. What about the ones you haven't quit? It doesn't mean that you will live any way you want because you have a reason to serve him. He saved you from sin and he saved you to live a sanctified life. But all of these messages, I want it to be clear, we're talking about justification, we're talking about salvation, and salvation is all of Jesus Christ. Job 25:4. How then can man be justified with God, or how can he be clean that is born of a woman? Who out there has been born of a woman? That's all of us. How can he be justified? Well, Romans 1:17 says, for therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. When we went through this in the first lesson, remember, is made alive by faith. It's being born again when you come to faith and trust in what Jesus did. Romans 4:16 says, therefore, it is of faith that it might be by grace. To the end, the promise might be sure to all the seed, not to that only which is of the law, but to that also which is of the faith of Abraham, who is the father of us all. In Romans, it's made pretty clear that there are those who were given the law. That's the Jewish people, the nation of Israel. There are those who weren't given the law, and they all stand condemned in terms of everyone is sinned. But those that put their faith in Christ will not stand for condemned because they will be justified. And it says the promise might be sure to all the seed. Now the seed is singular because that seed is talking about the seed that came from Abraham, which is Christ. And when you put your trust in Christ, Abraham is the father of us all because it's through his seed, which is Jesus Christ, that all people can be saved. Abraham's called the father of all those who believe. Have you believed on Christ? If you have, you have salvation. You know, a lot of things can get really confusing in Scripture. But one thing, if it's clear, if you have trusted Christ for salvation, if you've come to a place where it's all Him for your salvation, you've come to faith and you have eternal life. May the Lord bless you with the reading of His Word.